So let's try to define a hash function that has these properties. And what we want the hash function to do is to take a string as its input. We'll call the hash function hash underscore string. And it will produce as output a number between 0 and b. So we also need another input to our hash string, which is going to be the size of the hash table. So that'll be the second input, is the size of the hash table, the number of buckets. What we haven't seen yet that we're going to need for this function is a way to turn a string into a number. Python provides an operation to do that. It's called ord for ordinal. And what ord takes as its input is a one-letter string and produces as its output a number. And the actual mapping between strings and numbers is not so important. We just want something that's going to map different strings to different numbers. There's another operator that goes in the opposite direction that takes in a number and outputs the one-letter string that corresponds to that number. And the property these functions have is their inverses, that if we take the character corresponding to the ordinal corresponding to any one-letter string, we'll call that alpha, what we get as a result is the same alpha that we passed in. So let's try a few examples in the Python interpreter to see how ord and CHR work. So we'll print ord of A, and when we run that, we see we get the number 97. If we try print ord of capital A, that's different. We get 65. And if we print ord of B, we get 66. So the numbers are sort of sensible. B is higher than A. The lowercase letters have different ordinals than the uppercase. So if we try lowercase b, we should expect to get 98. And that is indeed what we get. And these are the numbers based on the ASCII and character encoding. What the actual numbers are not very important for us, other than that we get different numbers for different letters. So we'll be able to use the results of OR to make different strings hashed to different values. And just to show that they are inverses, if we do ord of u and then char of that, what we get back is the single letter string u that we started with. The limit of ord is it only works on one letter strings. If it provided a mapping from any string to a number that would be useful for a hash table, well, then we'd be done, but it doesn't do that. If we try running it on a multi-letter string, we get an error. It says that ord expects a single character, but it got a string of length 7. So we're gonna need to use ord only on single letter strings. So with ord, we have a way of converting strings to numbers, converting single character strings to numbers. The other property we need our hash function to have is that the output number is always between 0 and b minus 1. We need it to be in that range because we're gonna use that to index the list to find the bucket where that string belongs.